What's up, everybody? Max Cavalera here, and you're getting your fix on Metal Injection. Stay metal. Oi!
What's up, guys? I'm here with Max Cavalera. Whole family is pretty involved with metal overall, through management to performing. Do you think the family bond plays an important role in writing for Cavalera Conspiracy?
There's a side of what we do. I think it started with me and Igor, you know, because we're brothers and we started Sepultura, and so there was always family connection even from that point on. And then it continued through the years, you know. In fact, when I did Chaos AD, my son Heartbeat opens the album, you know, recorded when he was inside Gloria, you know. I recorded in the hospital and had the idea for that to be the intro of the record. And I always had a dream of having a metal family, you know, that was all involved in metal and in the projects. And now it's happening, you know. So we got my son playing drums now. My other kids have bands, and they help selling merchandise, so it's pretty kick-ass.
Richie is doing really well with his band, Insight, and as a parent, how does that make you feel, you know, him following in your steps?
Makes you feel good, man, you know, all of them, you know, Richie with the Insight, and Igor and Zion with Lodi Kong. I think they're going to get signed pretty soon, and hopefully they get a chance to make a record, because they're really kick ass. I love their stuff. And yeah, I mean, you know, what's cool also that they don't really ask for much help. They want to do it on themselves.
Right.
So they don't even ask me like tips about surviving this shit, which I would give them to them, but
does it make you a little nervous knowing like what's ahead and stuff that you've been through?
Yeah, but it's part of it, you know. I think it's part of it is discovering that, you know, you gotta go through the shit, make mistakes, you know, there's gonna be some frustration along the way, but that's all part of it. It's all part of
the learning process.
Of being a musician and getting into the music scene. But I think there's a lot of also positive things about in metal in general, you know, that's really cool. They're gonna learn that too.
Right.
So, you know, in general, I think it's good. But I think this attitude of them want to do them by themselves without much help from us, I think that's pretty cool. I appreciate that from them, you know.
The new album, Cavalier Conspiracies, Pandemonium. You could put it right up to Arise, and it won't skip a beat. You know, I mean, it's just super fast. You've worked with Igor so many times now. Is there anything that you do differently, or maybe challenge each other to try to keep it, you know, positive and fun for you guys?
Well, the making of Pandemonium for me was, out of the three records, the one I had more fun with it, because I really want to play fast with Igor and bring back our almost like teenage spirit of our teenage years.
Right.
When we first made Sepultura, we used to play fast, you know.
Right.
And it was all for the love of brutal music, you know. And it was cool to bring some of that back on the making of Pandemonium. And I was really rough when you were in the studio, but it was all for the good of the record. I really had a vision for the record, you know, to be a certain record that you put on, and it's like it makes a statement, you know. This album is fast, you know.
Right.
You don't hear that every day, you know.
And you can hear that right away when you put it on.
Yeah, it's there, you know. Almost out of the 10 songs, all of them are fast.
Yep.
So there's a couple groove parts here and there, but everything else is just D beats all the way. That's pretty much the formula of Pandemonium, is those two beats, one for verse, one for chorus. Just using a different way, the same formula for every song. but just twist it around a little bit to make it interesting, you know.
At this point, you have personally collaborated with so many amazing musicians. Who is your that unicorn for you? Who's that person that you've always wanted to collaborate with that you've never had a chance to?
What a few people I still want to work with. Al Jorgensen. Okay. I think a Nail Bomb kind of song with Al would be fucking awesome. With like my vocals and Al's vocals together in some kind of industrial metal song would be really, really cool. So I'm gonna probably try to make that happen in the future. I'm also connected with a lot of newer bands, so it would have been cool to do a song with, like, you know, with the Noisome guys or Full of Hell or one of the new bands, upcoming band Aborted, or Our Penance, or, you know, a lot of cool stuff out there. Like right now I listen to a lot of
New stuff. I love that you're really involved with like all the new bands coming out.
I like a lot of it. I listen to a lot of it. It's something that one of my favorite things to do is discovering new bands and, you know, I don't know, help them or try to spread their word more. Or, you know, I think it's what metal is about, that brotherhood.
Yeah.
You know, helping each other. And
if you had to put your thumb on a new band that's going to emerge that people should know about now, what do you think that would be?
For me, probably my favorite band right now is Our Penance out of Italy.
Awesome. Yeah,
the record is insane. And Aborted last record.
It's crazy.
Necrotic Manifesto.
It's insane.
They've been around for a while, and they got the death metal sound almost to perfection, you know. And,
right.
I love the cover of Arise they do too. It's one of my favorite Sepultura covers ever that anybody ever did. I think they managed to really do something amazing with it, you know, with the blast beat. And I show it to Igor, like, check this shit out, man. Look what those kids did to our song. But that's what cool about cover songs. It's interpretations, you know, different, just like we did with Sabbath.
Right, I was going to say, you do great covers. You really make it your own.
We grab Symptom of the Universe, and we throw a fast, hardcore beat in the middle of Symptom of the Universe. Sabbath would never thought of that, you know, so we put a stamp on a Sabbath song, and same what those kids, the Aborted kids do with Arise, with a blast beat. I wasn't expecting that, you know, so it's pretty kick-ass.
Keep an eye out for these guys coming on tour.